In this video, I want to explain logo rankings on LogoGround. Why do some logos rank higher than others? My name is André Roux. Let's get into some serious details. This is going to be a fun and entertaining video only if you like math. Just a heads up. This is more of a deep dive into the LogoGround machine for you to understand how to get your logos to rank higher up and to get more exposure. It is really worth it to understand this stuff. More exposure means more sales, obviously. Okay, that was your math warning. Let's begin. On your account overview page, you have your badges next to your avatar at the top. And right next to your badges, you have these ellipses. That is a link. If you click on it, it shows you the details of your badges and some other info that we want to take a look at. The first thing to understand is your designer reputation score. Positive actions like uploading a logo that is approved increases your designer reputation score, and negative actions like uploading a logo that is declined decreases your designer reputation score. On average, an approved logo gives you plus 1.2 reputation points, and a declined logo will cost you 0.8 reputation points. So let's say that you upload 20 logos, and let's say that of the 20, 15 are approved and 5 are declined. So you have 15 approved, that's 15 times 1.2, that gives 18, and 5 declined, that's 5 times 0.8, that gives 4. So these points are plus and these are minus, that gives you a total reputation score of 14. Remember that this is based on averages, so 14 is an estimate. The actual score can be a little higher or lower, but 14 will be pretty close to the mark. Okay, now let's suppose that you also sell two of your 15 approved logos. Every sale gives you plus 3. So if we add that to our sum, like that, our reputation score has now hit 20. And that is awesome news. 20 points means you've reached the silver designer level. And it's the same for the other levels. When you get to 100 points, you move up to gold. And at 500, you move up to platinum. Okay, but why should you care about your reputation score? Your logos each have their own score, and your reputation score impacts those logo scores. Let me show you. Let's put your 15 approved logos here, and we will add your designer reputation here, and let's give your logos some scores. This one has a big score. Maybe it got more likes, or it was selected as a star favorite, or maybe it made it all the way onto LogoGround's Instagram page, etc. There are many factors impacting the score, but the number of likes that it receives is a big factor. And here is somebody else. Let's call him Ben. Ben also has 15 logos, but Ben actually uploaded 30 logos and half were declined. So he has a reputation score of only 6, more or less, if my math is correct. And let's give Ben's logos the same scores as your logos, just for comparison. Let's say that Ben also sold 2 logos to make it fair. So Ben has 12 reputation. Now we can see that these two profiles are not equal. It is clear that you understand logos slightly better than Ben does. You had fewer declined logos, so it is reasonable to assume that on average your logos are slightly better than Ben's logos. So LogoGround wants your logos to rank slightly higher than Ben's logos. And the way it does that is it takes your designer reputation score and it uses it to modify your logo scores. The real calculation here is extremely complex, but to keep it simple, let's say that LogoGround simply adds the reputation score to the logo scores. like that. That will do to illustrate the concept. So your logos each receive plus 20, and poor Ben, his logos each receive plus 12, like that. So now if someone does a search on LogoGround, this logo will show first. It has the highest score. The next highest is this one by Ben, and then all of these logos come next before Ben's next logo. So your logos will on average outrank Ben's logos because you had fewer declined logos. Okay, if you are still with me, the other important thing to understand is badges. They also impact your logo rankings. If you scroll down the page a bit, you will see your badge details. These general badges here do not impact your rankings, so let's skip them. The rest all matter for rankings. So, for example, the upload badge. I have more than 100 logos, but I don't yet have 1,000. So I have the silver badge for upload activity, and so on. What LogoGround does is it looks at how many badges you have, and it uses that to again modify your logo scores. The more badges you have, the more points get added to your logos. LogoGround does not just count the badges. Obviously, a gold badge is more valuable than a silver badge, so it adds more points. And not all badges are the same. For example, your forum participation badge gives you some points, but not a lot. Anyone can post on the forum, so that does not tell LogoGround much about the quality of your logos. But forum participation is good for the community and it helps your fellow designers, so you do get some bonus points for being active on the forum. Then you have a badge like this one, the approval record. That is a very, very important badge. If you can get 10 logos approved in a row, not interrupted by declined logos, that says something. It says not only are you someone who can design good logos, but you are also doing it consistently, and you are paying attention to details and following the rules and maybe a bit of a perfectionist. So that is a big positive quality signal. If you can get that badge, it adds a lot of points to all your logos. And obviously, if you can get 100 approved in a row, you're a genius and LogoGround loves you and all your logos rank much higher. At the time that I'm recording this, no one has the perfectionist badge yet. That's the 1,000 in a row. But there are two designers who are well on their way. They are doing great. We wish them luck. It's a big task. And the final thing that I want to show you for this video is that not all badges are available to everyone. You can see here that the upload activity badge, for example, is available to silver level designers and higher, meaning that you have to get to 20 reputation points and get that silver designer level before you can get this badge. If you don't get to at least the silver level, your logos will not rank high up on LogoGround and you will find it hard to make sales. So focus on getting to silver and then gold and platinum. And the best way to do that is to have as few declined logos as possible. That's it for this video. Well done for making it all the way to the end. Class dismissed. Thanks for watching.